is the election of a second Donald Trump administration in the cards for 2024. It's almost completely ignored by the lamestream media, but yes, I definitely think so. If the Donald wants, and I think he does. And if the latest Harvard-Harris poll is any indication, it just might as far as the average low information off the street voter is concerned, so that's a good sign, right? Now, I want to apologize up front if I sound a little off in this one. There's a damn good chance my darling daughter brought home the bad stew the other day, at least according to a Walgreens test result. But then again, who knows with these tests, right? They're about as reliable as the jab, I hear. Anyways, I'm feeling a little under the weather, long and short of it. Okay, so producing results that will have leftists waking up in cold sweats, the poll shows that Trump leads current imposter Joe Biden 48% to 45% in a hypothetical rematch. It also shows that Trump's leadership in the White House is preferred by 4 points. Now, let's keep in mind that in some way, shape, or form, Harvard University had at least something to do with this poll. So, with that being said, the numbers are probably at least 10 times worse for the Democrats. But while few really believe the Democrats can actually keep Biden, well, on 2 feet and able to run again in 3 years from now, Trump also beat Kamala Harris and Pete Buttigieg by a large amount in that same poll. We'll go over the details right after this quick commercial break to pay some bills. It's no secret that liberals are waging a war on the Second Amendment, and Trump supporters, of course. Make no mistake, the Democrats and Joe Biden are on the war path to further erode the Second Amendment, and eventually, sooner or later, take your guns. As such, we can no longer stand back and watch the values that founded this great nation be trampled on any further. As a proud American in this God-fearing, gun-toting nation, we must stand up and fight for our rights to bear arms and the Second Amendment in every way. That's why, for a limited time only, Trump-supporting gun lovers will be able to receive a buy one, get one free limited edition gold-plated Second Amendment Is My Gun Permit coin. This amazing Second Amendment Is My Gun Permit coin is on track to become the most popular Second Amendment memorabilia out there. And as always, liberals can't stand it, which should be a good enough reason to own a couple anyway. You can pick them up by hitting that link in the description box below. Support the Second Amendment while supporting this channel. Plant that puppy proudly on your mantle or fireplace so there's never a question on where you stand. Okay, so Poll Tracker tweeted out 2024 National General Election Poll. Trump 48% plus 11 over Pete Buttigieg 37%. Trump 58% plus 9 over Kamala Harris 41%. There's very little reason to believe at this point that Pete Buttigieg and Kamala Harris lack name recognition, which can often explain early poll results like this. Sometimes you'll see large amounts of undecideds, with the more well-known person leading at around 40%. That's not really indicative of anything. But in this case, Trump touches or nearly touches 50% against two of the most high-profile Democrats in the country. Now, another interesting aspect of this poll is who Democrats would prefer as their 2024 nominee. Right now, believe it or not, Biden leads that measure with 31%, which is to be expected, I guess, if you're a Democrat. Why? Because every day is an IQ test when you're a Democrat. And Democrats fail that test every day. Just look around. It's pretty obvious. But what should haunt Democrats' dreams is that Kamala Harris holds a firm second place and takes over the top spot if Beijing Biden is removed from the race. Now, as we've speculated in the past, the Democrats really have no out with Harris now, do they? They're just kind of stuck with her. She checks all the identity boxes and is radical enough that a sizable portion of their base, meaning guilt-ridden White House wives and free shit parasites, will back her no matter what. Yet, she's about as unlikable as it gets. She is an awful general election candidate, kind of like MSNBC's position with Joy Reid. They are completely stuck. They're royally screwed. Now, if the lovely Democrat establishment tries to throw Harris under the bus like they did Bernie Sanders, there will be a big backlash amongst their voters. You know, the children of the DNC burning down their neighborhood stores and whatnot over racism or some nonsense. In short, barring some major, and I mean major shift, it's Biden or Harris in 2024. It's beautiful. This poll did provide results on some possible Republican primary matchups as well. Trump leads with 67% if he chooses to run. Meanwhile, Ron DeSantis takes the top spot if Trump doesn't run, with Mike the sellout Pence in second place. And while DeSantis somehow trails Buttigieg and Harris head-to-head, keep in mind, once again, it's a Harvard poll. The latter two are mired in the low 40s. That's the common situation I mentioned earlier about name recognition. Remember, these are low-information voters, at best. When you have someone who has never ran for president, they almost always start low with the high undecided number, in this case, 21%. We'd have to see how such matchups would poll in a more settled environment, so to speak. Regardless, if Trump has the inkling to run, which I think he does, polls like this are further evidence he could be easily successful. The one caveat I would mention, though, is that Trump is most popular with the broader electorate when he's pointing out all the idiocy you and I see, and the media doesn't, going on with this current regime every damn day. Right now, all you really get from the Donald are press releases and the occasional interview. Lastly, this poll really shows that voters, by growing margins, see Biden as too old and unhealthy to be president, amongst, I'm sure, a lot of other issues. That it took this long for most of these morons to get there is a bit astounding, but better late than never, I guess. In the end, it's extremely early, but these results are interesting nonetheless. If you're looking for an overarching theme rather than something specifically predictive, I think what you can take from this is that Democrats are in big, big trouble. All right, that's about it for that one. Most of this came by way of redstate.com. If you liked it, hit that like button. Subscribe if you haven't. Leave a comment down below. There's a PayPal link in the description box, so please put a dollar in the bucket on the way out the door. I'd like to thank everyone for all your donations. They're much needed and much appreciated. Now, with all that being said, we'll see you next time.
Come on, move. Move. Easy.